lineups look like this. First for the Owasso Rams, the head coach is Mark Van Curen. Their starters remain the same. DeShannon Lowe, Max Seaflew, Kinzer Lambert, TU football commit Michael Anderson, and of course the defending Gatorade State Player of the Year, Shake Milton, signed with SMU. The starting lineup for the Memorial Chargers, their head coach is Bobby Allison. They got here by beating Edmond Santa Fe yesterday in the semifinals. Santa Fe went on to beat Victory Christian earlier today by 10 points. Their starters look like this. One of the guards, Caleb Nero, Taylor Ellison, who is a sharpshooter from three-point range, Alec Boskostov, a 6'2" senior. Then you have a 6'4" junior, Derek Guest. And then finally, the UT San Antonio signee, 6'8" senior, A.J. Cochran, rounds out the starting lineup for the Memorial Chargers, wearing their home white uniforms, Memorial across the front in red trimmed in blue. Owasso wearing their road maroon uniforms with a big bold Rams across the front trimmed in black. Championship game between the Chargers and Rams about to take place here on your home for sports, the sports animal. Matt, I talked about the three keys to this game, really, for both teams. Shake Milton cannot shoot 20 free throws tonight if Memorial wants to win. He's averaging about 21 free throws per game during this tournament stretch. Michael Anderson has to stay on the floor and contest with A.J. Cockrell and avoid foul trouble. And finally, the complement players. We know that A.J. is going to have a big game. We know Shake's going to have a big game. Who's going to step up besides those players? Those are the three big keys in this game, in this championship matchup, as A.J. Cockrell and Kinzer Lambert are at half court ready to get things started.
I think this game will come down to the supporting cast and not the two key players, that is Shake Milton on one side for the Owasso Rams and on the other side for the Memorial Chargers, A.J. Cockrell. I think we'll have to look at the supporting cast.
Cockrell and Lambert. Cockrell wins the opening tap. Tips it back to Nero, who's going to be met by Lambert. Nero angles to his left towards the Owasso bench. Goes to Cockrell. Now out to Boskostov for three. Off the back iron, no good. Anderson battling with his own teammate for the rebound. They give it to Lambert. Lambert crosses half court. Memorial empty on their first possession. Lambert attacking the Memorial defense. Loses control of the ball. Out of bounds. Last touch by Caleb Nero. And he'll stay with the Rams. Shannon Lowe inbounds to Milton. Milton shot off the glass and in, and out the basket. Beautiful. It only took him about 28 seconds to get to the free throw line. Shake Milton has shot 42 free throws in the last 2 days.
Shake Milton doing Shake Milton things by getting to the line there, fighting through contact. Milton faced some really harsh contact last night, and I was just very impressed with him, the way he was able to keep battling through it.
3 points for Milton. Makes the free throw. By the way, he keeps getting to the free throw line, and just in case you're wondering, he converts on nearly 90% of his foul shots over the last 2 days. 3-0 early. Owasso down on the block. A.J. Cockrell gets it, working on Anderson. Cockrell trying to get around the big man and travels with him.
Shake Milton, not as tall as Kevin Durant, but from the free throw line, he definitely hits like Kevin Durant, as both of them around 90%.
Everything about his game is reminiscent to Kevin Durant.
I would really agree with you. Now, he's obviously a little shorter, but
with the exception of his height.
Yeah,
that's about the only thing.
Very talented young man headed off to SMU.
The Rams turned the ball over. Right back over to Memorial. The Chargers getting an opportunity here. Taking a look at Bobby Allison, trying to lead the Chargers to the TOC Championship. Both of these teams hope that this is the first of two trips to the Mavis Center. The 6A and 5A state championships held here in March. We got a long way to go, and off a lazy pass, Shake Milton going the other way. Two-hand slam for the SMU signee.
He can do just about everything you need on offensive and defensive end.
The pass to Guest on the right wing pulls up. He's guarded heavily by Milton. Milton going to get called for the reach in, and That was an easy call for the referee as Milton had good positioning, but he came over the top of Guest, so it's an easy call for the ref.
Anytime any player comes over the top, it's going to be an easy foul call. The same with that
one. Osco Saab set to inbound. He throws it into Ellison. Ellison finds Guest. Guest guarded by Milton. Nearly 2 minutes into the first quarter, Memorial yet to score. 5-0 in favor of Shake Milton. I'm sorry, Owasso. I say that tongue-in-cheek. Milton has all 5 points. Until now, it's 5-3. Taylor Ellison strikes with a dagger three.
You said he was a sharp shooter. That was probably the most true statement I've ever heard out of your mouth. He truly is. He cannot leave Milton.
Shake Milton with a floater in the lane. No good. Gets his own miss. Nice little drop pass to Michael Anderson. Such savvy basketball IQ from Shake Milton there to drop the pass down low. Knew that Anderson was behind Cockrell and was going to get an easy two-point basket. 7-3 is the score. 5:40 left in the first quarter. Ellison has the top of the key. Bosco stop. Now angles to the top. Now they'll hand it off to Guest. Guest puts the ball on the deck only to toss it to Nero. Nero working on Lambert, bounce pass to Guest, open for three, launches, in and out, no good. Bosco stop battling with Seafood for the rebound. He comes up
great
with
hustle.
It, tosses it to Taylor Ellison.
Great hustle on that play.
Nero walking over to the right, now driving baseline, and we're going to get a foul. Max Seafluth, I believe. It was.
Foul number 12, Max Seafluth. His first personal foul, the second Owasso team foul.
Inbound pass to Taylor Ellison. Ellison shuffled his feet, got away with it. Entry pass to Cockrell underneath. He goes up with a shot, no good. Got his own miss and put back. It's 7-5 in favor of the Owasso Rams. Anderson, good defense there that time, avoiding the foul call, but Cockrell is just too good. Also has about 3 to 4 inches on Anderson. Lambert has it right wing. Derek Guest face guarding Shake Milton. DeShannon Lowe now top of the key, drives to the basket, working on Taylor Ellison. Ellison takes the charge, and it'll turn over to the Chargers. Nero walking it up to half court. 4.5 minutes left. 7-5 is the score. Nero angles to his right. New entry into the game for Memorial. Driving to the basket and getting stuffed was the new entry, Alante Carson. Sophomore had no shot going in at Michael Anderson. Carson set to trigger the inbound pass, looking for an open man. And Bobby Allison calls the 30-second timeout. Carson checked in for Bosco Staub, who sat down. 4:19 left in the first quarter. Owasso leads 7-5. Shake Milton for 5 points. In fact, all 7 points for Owasso here in the first half of the first quarter have been responsible, or Shake Milton has been responsible for them as he scored five. And on the two-point basket from Michael Anderson, he had the assist.
And he talked about that assist. What I loved about that, Shake Milton is not only one of the most talented basketball players, he has one of the highest IQs you'll see around the country. Whereas he saw the double team, and before the double team even got to him, he saw it, recognized it, and dished that ball off to Anderson for the easy basket.
He's unselfish. I mean, he knows that he's the best player on the floor, and he knows if his team is going to have success, he's going to have to take over games. But he wants his team and his teammates to share in that success.
Yeah, exactly. Very humble.
Owasso nearly seals the inbound pass. It goes out of bounds and stays with the Chargers. Nero controlling the point for Memorial. They go underneath to Cockrell in between two defenders. No good. Trying to get his own miss. Milton had the positioning up ahead to Lambert. Lambert all the way to the basket for the layup. 9-5 in favor of Owasso. Under 4 minutes to go in the first quarter. Do you give Shake the assist on that one?
Yes. Sure.
Responsible for all 9. Nero attacking the basket. Throws a wild shot off the glass. Cockrell gets the offensive board. The putback is off the mark. Milton up ahead in the front court for Owasso. 3-on-4. Milton takes it himself up and under. Layup with the left hand. It's too easy.
It's a Shake Milton show tonight.
11-5, 3.5 minutes left in the first quarter. Carson, right in front of the Owasso coaches. He attacks, drives right past Blake Hamer. Forces Hamer the foul. Now you put up a floater, they're not going to count it. He'll be on the floor.
Blake Hamer with his first personal foul.
Carson set to trigger the inbound pass. He throws it in to Taylor Ellison, but Ellison got so wide open because Boswell stopped. Set to leave the screen.
Something to watch this when I wanted to see who would come out and get off to the early hot start. It's been a while, so in the Memorial, if they don't watch out, they might find themselves in a hole too big to get out of.
Shake Milton walking up to half court. 11-5 is the score. Rams for the early lead. Bounce pass to Shannon Lowe. Free throw line to Seafluth underneath. Pass to Milton, tipped away and stolen by the Chargers. Boswell stopped, carried the ball. He wanted to do a bounce pass to Nero. He saw that the lane closed up, changed his mind mid-handle, and ended up palming the ball.
Costly turnover, just as Memorial thinking maybe that can get their momentum going. They just turn it right back over to the Rams.
Max Seafluth checked back in earlier, but now has to sit down. Michael Anderson got about 20 seconds worth of rest.
Enough time to take about 2 sips of water.
Memorial going into some full court trapping defense to Shannon Lowe in the corner to Lambert. Lambert working on a new entry into the game from Memorial. Lambert drives into the paint, jumps up into the air and forces the foul.
Number 25, Jalen
Alexander, Jalen Alexander, a junior, gets the foul call underneath. Nice backdoor cut from Kinzer Lambert, another player who has a high basketball IQ. Kinzer understands how to get open.
Kinzer's starting to become a premier second scorer right behind Shake on this team.
13-5 is the score. 2.5 minutes left in the first quarter. That was the first point that wasn't attributed to Shake Milton in some way. Jump shot by Nero, off the mark to the right. Offensive rebound. What a play by Alexander underneath, going up with the putback off the mark, but he gets 2 free throws. That was just hustling.
Great hustle, and he'll get rewarded with a trip to the free throw line. Memorial really needs him to hit these free throws so they can get back in this one and get things closed up before they get too far.
The thing about Memorial, though, they're never out of the game because they have players like Taylor Ellison, like Alex Boskostov, like some of the others that can just knock down three after three. But that, you know, Owasso has pretty good perimeter defense. So it's going to be interesting. And Shake Milton takes a rare seat on the bench.
Wait a second. He gets rest in games?
He's played a lot of minutes over the last 2 days.
I say that with complete sarcasm because I don't remember seeing him in this tournament setting out 1 minute. I'm sure he has at some point, and possibly. But I know his minutes are very high in that overtime game last night, feeding into this game.
Yeah, I don't think he sat out a single minute during that game. Rams up ahead. Seafluth underneath, attacking Cockrell. There's no chance. Cockrell rejects it. Seafluth comes up with a loose ball. The pass out, intercepted by Carson, who goes coast to coast. Layup low! To Shannon Lowe running down the loose ball. It goes out of bounds.
Those are the type of possessions Memorial has to cash in and cannot keep giving the ball right back to Owasso.
To Shannon Lowe adjusted the layup and made Carson concerned about him and then forced the turnover. Seafluth ahead to Lowe for three. Got it! To Shannon Lowe. 16-7 in favor of the Rams.
Big huge shot there by Lowe.
Huge sweep sequence there for Lowe. Carson to his left. A foul away from the ball, and it's on Memorial.
I might think to call a timeout here, but you do have a minute 34.
Number 11,
just before this first quarter, so Coach Allison may just elect to let the quarter in.
Plus Memorial.
For Memorial.
Memorial has already used one timeout here in the first. Up ahead underneath, Michael Anderson down low. He gets the basket off the glass. Anderson with four early points. It's a double-digit lead, 18-7. Carson into the corner. Guest for three. Got it. And one. Michael Anderson, just a silly play, closing in, trying to contest the shot.
That's the type of play Memorial needs, though, something to get them going.
Well, absolutely. Nothing like a four-point play to get back in the game.
No doubt about it. And they hit this right here. They can hit this free throw. 18-11, not terrible.
Free throw on the way. Got it. Nice 4-point swing by Derek Guest. Minute 15 left, 18-11. Some pressure now from Memorial. To Shannon Lowe to his right, to Kinsler Lambert. Lambert to his left to Lowe. Lowe thought about triggering the three. Now they go into the right corner to Blake Hamer, who travels with it.
Here's Memorial's chance. Get back into this thing. You hit a basket, it's a 5-point game, possibly even a 4-point game with the three.
Milton must be tired from the last 2 days, because I can't think of another reason for him to be sitting this last minute, 2 minutes out here in the first quarter. Pass into the corner. Derek Guest launches for three. This one's short. Anderson trying to run down the loose ball. Memorial comes up with it. They throw it back to Guest into the corner. Pump faking the three, and shuffling his feet was Jontre Berry, the sophomore. Now a new entry into the game for Owasso, as Michael Anderson will sit down for the rest of the quarter. Greg Holman.
Three straight days of playing in a tournament like this, you've played at all different times of the day, it can definitely wear on you, and I think you're seeing that on both sides with players getting some rest.
Kinsler Lambert goes to his left, now back to Lambert. Into the corner to Lowe. Lowe underneath, what a bounce pass to Seafluth, who finished with the right hand. 20-11, under 20 seconds to go, up ahead to Ellison, back to Guest. Guest driving into the paint. Floater, no good. Cockrell's there for the putback. He counted. He was fouled going up. He'll go to the free throw line to try to complete the old-fashioned three-point play. With 9 seconds left, it would put Memorial within six.
It's a beautiful play there by A.J. Cockrell. He's been fairly silent through the first half. First quarter, I should say, but starting to get going here at the end.
Cockrell makes it 20-14. Give A.J. 5 points here.
And A.J.'s going to get a rest. Smart coaching move there by Coach Allison. Knowing the quarter is about to come up with 9 seconds left, giving a little bit extra rest.
Lambert goes to his left. Now to Seafluth. Back to Lambert. Stolen away. But Nero didn't understand, didn't see that there was only 2 seconds left. Couldn't get a shot up in time. And we've reached the end of the first quarter. Owasso out on top, 20-14. You're listening to the Tournament of Champions title game here on your own for sports, Sports Animal.
From two stories to 20. From ready apps to emergency response. From your community to a nationwide network. The cleanup specialists at 1-800-SERVPRO. Everything under your roof, everyone under ours. Helping to make fire and water damage like it never even happened. From restoring damage in just one room to an entire building, turn to the cleanup team that's here in your community and here to help at 1-800-SERVPRO. Like it never even happened.
Start the second quarter. It's 20-14 in favor of the Owasso Rams. Kinzer Lambert has it right wing. Surveying the Memorial defense. Now crosses over. Driving. Hands off to Seafood. Seafood tosses back to Milton. Milton working on possible stops. Step back jumper. Knocked down. That's. It's just. It's almost like it's not fair. Milton with the bucket to start the second quarter. 22-14. Guest tosses to his left. To Nero. Back to Guest. Top of the key. To his right to possible stop. Possible stop. Pounds pass to Ellison. Ellison. Right back to possible stop. Who was being harassed by DeShannon Lowe. He stepped on the end line out of bounds. DeShannon Lowe is just a pest on defense.
Lowe is having a big impact. You may not always see Lowe having big numbers scoring-wise, but overall just has a big impact on this Rams squad.
Lambert hands off to Milton. Milton walking up to the three-point line to pull up. No good on the shot. Cockrell skies for the rebound. Bounce pass underneath to Cockrell. Cockrell finishes with a left hand. Nice look from Alec Boskostov on the perimeter. Back the other way comes Kinzer Lambert and Owasso spinning around Nero. Shot off the glass is good.
Kinzer Lambert stepping up big here in the first half.
Underneath to A.J. Cockrell. Cockrell answers. 24-18, Cockrell with 9 points here in the first half. Had his first ever 20-20 game last night. 27 points, 20 boards, and a win over Edmond Santa Fe. Shake Milton driving to the basket. No, he passes to Anderson, who's there for the finish, and Cockrell's hurt. He hooked the pass around Cockrell, and Anderson finished with the left hand. Nero on the drive, shot no good.
Memorial hanging around in this one. They'll need a very big key for me for Memorial in this one. You have to shoot about 85 to 90% from the free throw line if you're going to want to win this game, because when you get there, there's a reason why they call them free throws. They're free. So use them to your advantage and cash in.
Yes. I'd agree with that. I'd agree with every word that you just said. No arguments here. Nero made the first free throw. Makes it 26-19. 6 minutes and 2 seconds remain in the second quarter. A.J. Cockrell with 9 points. Shake Milton with 9 points. Off the second free throw miss. Give Cockrell 11. He gets the offensive board in the putback. It's 26-21.
That's what he does. That is A.J. Cockrell right there.
He's turning into a man before our eyes, and I'm more and more impressed every time I see him.
UT San Antonio is getting a great one.
UT San Antonio is getting a steal. That's what they're getting. By the end of his senior season, Cockrell could be a mid-major to low Power 5 conference recruit. Shake Milton on the floater. Rebounded by Cockrell off the miss. He'll hand it off to Carson. Carson up ahead for Memorial. He'll go to Boskostov. Boskostov into the corner. Three ball on the way by Nero. It's off the mark. Offensive board by Guest. Nice bounce pass to Cockrell. He can't finish, but he's going to the free throw line to shoot two. Hey, look at it. Because of the early signing period, UT San Antonio is getting a steal. By the end of his season, man, Cockrell is going to be a huge commodity.
We saw it last year with some players. Sean Olden, it took a little bit for him at Union to start getting offers. Got it very late, actually after the season. But maybe if AJ doesn't sign early, he could go to definitely a bigger school than UT San Antonio. I know we're talking with him. He's very excited about going to the city of San Antonio. I would be too.
Never been.
Great city. Gotta go.
I'll try. Cockrell missed the first. He made the second. 26-22 is the score. Cockrell now has 12 points. Probably, I'm just guessing off the top of my head, 6 or 7 rebounds for the big man. Kinzer Lambert driving to the basket, and he had to, it was like parting of the Red Sea. He drove to the basket, and no one was there to defend it. Easy layup for Lambert. He has 8 points.
Kinzer's having a big time first half for Lawson.
He's averaging 17 points a game, or a little less than that. as Moskostov can't control the pass. That was the age-old deal where he looked around before he actually controlled it. He goes out of bounds and over to the Rams. Lambert, only a junior, has the potential to turn into one of those lower Division I type recruits. I don't want to put him at the same level as Sean Olden because he's not as athletic, but that type of player. Milton underneath the basket, got past Boskostar, made the basket, and a whistle. I don't know if they're going to say this is a foul after the shot or during the shot. Milton made the basket, and then the referee blew his whistle. They're going to give Milton Greenley 11 points for Shea. Another trip to the free throw line.
The big thing with Kendrick Lambert is that he can be a scoring force and be that second-tier scorer. Right behind Shea Milton this year. This Owasso team, the sky is the limit.
Shake makes another free throw. Good news for Memorial, though, is he's not on pace for 20-plus free throws here tonight. 31-22 is the score. Owasso on top. 4.5 minutes left in the second quarter. Rams want a trap. Milton forcing a steal. He's going to attack the Charger defense, working around Boskostov. Out to Blake Hamer. Hamer drives, bounce pass to Anderson. Anderson going at Cockrell, leaves it off the front iron. Cockrell grabs the board.
Great defense there by Cockrell.
Tosses to Guest, into the corner. Carson launches for three, no good. Anderson battling for the rebound, does a great job boxing out Cockrell. Didn't come up with it, Lambert did. Milton on the drive. Throws it off the backboard, and literally off the spin, it goes into the cup. Unbelievable shot.
He does amazing things.
33-22. Guest for three. Before he launches, he traveled with it. With 3:35 left, Shake Milton starting to heat up. He's got 14 points. Bobby Allison senses that Owasso is in the midst of going on a run and things could get way out of hand in a hurry before halftime. He takes a timeout. It's a 60. We'll take it with him. 3:35 left in the second quarter. This is the Tournament of Champions title game here on your home for sports. Sports Animal.
Under the roof of a home or business, damage can happen. When it does, turn to the specialists who put help in the palm of your hand. The Ready App and Emergency Response Plans from 1-800-SERV-PRO, like it never even happened.
Doing a great job. In studio producer, Kenny Brunson doing a great job this week.
Foul on number three, Shake Milton, his third. That is the.
Owasso there turns over the ball. This is a chance for Memorial. You're down by 11. You need to get something going here before the half so you get some momentum into the second half.
Nero crosses half court and he's going to slow things down. Gives it to Ellison, wide open in the corner. There was contact, no call. Ball rattles around, no good. Cockrell runs down the loose ball. Guest launches from the free throw line, no good. Outlet pass to Lambert off the Hamer rebound. He has it right wing, attacking the defense. Hands off to Lowe. Lowe turns around and gives it to Seifluth, who tosses to Lambert. Shake Milton not in the game right now. Hamer to Seafruth right wing. Out to Hamer. Hamer tosses to Lambert. Lambert's right wing. Ball goes out of bounds. It's going to stay with Owasso.
I think the biggest reason why Shake Milton, obviously going through these 3 days, he's had incredible games of 51 and then 43 last night. He's obviously tired, but you're able to leave him on the bench right now because of how well Kinsler Lambert is playing in this first half with 8 points.
Owasso inbound pass to Seafluth. They give it to Hamer. Hamer surveying the defense. In the corner, goes top of the key to Lambert. Lambert, right-handed yo-yo dribble, will hand off to Low from Rass, and he's going to be fouled. 2:14 left. 33-22 is the score. Owasso on top. Again, no indication on why Shake Milton is spending more time than normal on the bench. One can only assume it's because of the fact that he's played a lot of basketball over the last 2 days. Lambert, right wing, goes top of the key to Hamer. Hamer walks with it before he dribbled, no call, pass to Low off the glass, no good, rebound to Cockrell, but there's a foul on the shot.
At the free throw line will be Shannon Lowe.
Lowe set to shoot free throws.
2 hours and 5 minutes from the new year.
You know, I was wondering before the girls' championship game, like if we had some delays and things like that, maybe an overtime, double overtime, could we be ringing in the new year with the tournament of champions?
This game would have to go. Like seven overtimes long.
Quadruple overtime. Lowe made both free throws. Nero crosses half court, tosses to his left. Under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Memorial needs something here on this possession. Guest had a three ball, didn't take it. Underneath to Cockrell, who finishes with the right hand. 14 points for AJ. Minute 40, 35-24. Lambert, right wing. Gets a pick from Anderson. Dribbles right past Cockrell. Attacks the glass, ball rolls around and falls, count the basket, and give him a free throw.
Great move to the basket by Kinsler Lambert, and what can you say about the first half Kinsler's having after yesterday? I know from talking to him after the game, he only had 4 points in the half, wasn't really happy with his performance, and in the halftime locker room, Coach Van Kuren challenged him, came out and had a big time in the second half, where today he's just starting off where he's tip.
Lambert misses the free throw. Guest goes to Nero. Nero for three. No good. Rebound all the way out to Lambert on the three-point line. He crosses half court. Minute 15 left. Rams up 37-24. Lambert, dribble drive. Bounce pass to Seafluth. Seafluth, backdoor cut to Low. Low collides with Guest. Ball goes out of bounds. Bobby Allison runs over to toss the ball to one of the referees. I swear, he drinks like 5 Red Bulls before every game. The dude is amped.
He's amped every game. It doesn't matter who they're playing.
Nero under a minute to go for the Chargers, 37-24. Angles to the top of the key, bounce pass to the top of the key, left wing to Guest. Guest, dribble drive, tosses it out to Nero, 45 seconds. Floater in the lane, shot off to the right, no good. It will be free throws for Caleb Nero. Only a sophomore. Memorial having to reload a lot off last year's state championship team. And they're reloading with some young talent. Memorial a threat to contend this year.
Shooter is Caleb Nero.
And in the next several years.
It's more like Memorial. Yes, everybody was like, oh, they lost this, they lost that. Well, they just reload. That's just what they do.
Back-to-back champs. Nero made both free throws, 37-26, 35 seconds left. Lambert tosses to his left to Low. Low at the free throw line, bounce pass to Lambert, back to Seafluth. Seafluth picks up his dribble, needing some help, goes left wing to Lambert. 20 seconds left. Lambert working on Boston stop. Crosses him over, blows past him. Layup met by Cockrell. He got over the big man. He was fouled. The shot was no good, but he's going to get two free throws. That could have been ugly, but he got it over the big man. Impressive.
He did, and when you look at it, that's AJ's second foul. Cockrell, not in foul trouble yet necessarily, but you'd like if you just go into the halftime. We got 14 seconds left with him not picking up that second foul.
Lambert misses the first free throw. 14.2 seconds left. Second free throw is good. 38-26. Lambert now with 11 points. Up ahead goes Guest. Under 10 seconds to go. Guest, top of the key, into the corner. Carson for three. Got it. Actually, that was Caleb Nero right before the end of the second quarter. Nero knocking down a three. 38-29 is the score. Owasso on top. Shake Milton seeing limited minutes, but he's got 14. AJ Cockle has 14 minutes for a Memorial. We've reached halftime of the 2014 Tournament of Champions title game here on your home for sports, Sports Animal.
From two stories to 20. From ready apps to emergency response. From your community to a nationwide network. The cleanup specialists at 1-800-SERVPRO. Everything under your roof, everyone under ours. Helping to make fire and water damage like it never even happened. From restoring damage in just one room to an entire building, turn to the cleanup team that's here in your community and here to help at 1-800-SERVPRO, like it never even happened. Under the roof of a home or business, damage can happen. When it does, turn to the specialists who put help in the palm of your hand, the Ready App and Emergency Response Plans from 1-800-SERVPRO, like it never even happened.
Their names and record-making skills were intertwined during their high school careers. They were the top two scorers in the state as seniors in 2008. They each led their teams to state championships that year. They each earned All-State honors. They are the two leading scorers in boys' state history. But tonight, we are recognizing their accomplishments, and they are ready from their playing days in the Tournament of Champions. First of all, let's recall that day in December of 2007, when Paige and Clark met for the only time in their storied high school careers. It was the second round of the Tournament of Champions. So many people lined up outside the Fairgrounds Pavilion that tournament officials held up the tip-off for 35 minutes. First, he delayed it for 20 minutes. Still, hundreds, maybe a thousand and more, remained outside, and they delayed it another 15 minutes. Once every seat inside the venerable basketball arena was filled, and then some, the scoreboard said it was Class 2A, number one Pawnee, versus 3A, number one Vertebrates. The 5,000 hardy souls who had braved the elements said it was Page versus Clark. Clark scored 34 for Vertebrates. Page scored 28 for Pawnee. Pawnee won 57-49 for those keeping track of such statistics. By the time the second game of the day was tipping off, more than half the crowds had departed. For them, there was only one game, two players that mattered. Clark finished the tournament with 87 points on games of 34, 28, and 25. He was an all-tournament selection for the second straight year. As a junior in 2006, Rodney Clark led all tournament scores with 104 points. He had games of 31, 38, and 35, and finished with 35 points more than the runner-up, who was Keaton Page. In his two appearances in the Tournament of Champions, Clark accumulated 191 points for fourth place all time. His 104 points in 2006 rank as the sixth best all time. Clark went on to play collegiately at Arkansas and Butler. He is currently playing professionally in Belgium. Ladies and gentlemen, Hall of Famer Rodney Clark. Keaton Page is the only the second player ever to earn three consecutive All-Tournament honors. Following New Lyman's Hall of Fame Eddie Louie, as a sophomore in 2005, he led all tournament scorers with 75 points. As a junior, he was second in scoring as Pawnee finished fourth. Page won the tournament's Most Valuable Player Award as a senior in 2007, leading all scorers with 123 points, the second best three-game series in tournament history. His high game was 55 in the consolation finals, and that still ranks as the third highest single game mark in tournament history. For his nine games over 3 years, Keaton Page owns the tournament career record scoring of 272 points. Following his career at Pawnee, Page played collegiately at Oklahoma State, where today he is a member of the athletic department. Ladies and gentlemen, Hall of Famer Keaton Page. Let's have another big hand for Rodney Clark and Keaton Page, two of the greatest players ever to play in this tournament. Now we are going to honor another group. 50 years ago, even though all these guys look way too much younger for them to have been playing that long ago, but anyway, 50 years ago, our first champion was the in that first tournament. We have many of them with us tonight. We're going to call their name out and ask them to come on to the floor. Odell Bynum, Danny Boydston, Jerry Bullard, Tim Cameron, Tom Cameron, Larry Carter, John Daniel, Keith Lumberback, Frank Mitchell, Dick Knox, Ronnie Reynolds, and Roy Whiteley. The Cadet coach was the late Boyd Linden. And ladies and gentlemen, they ended up in Class B unbeaten and number one ranked. And the entire team was inducted into the Hall of Fame in 2002. Let's have a big hand for our first champion, the Inola Longhorns.
Stories to 20. From ready apps to emergency response. From your community to a nationwide network. The cleanup specialists at 1-800-SERVPRO. Everything under your roof, everyone under ours. Helping to make fire and water damage like it never even happened. Yeah.
It's so good.
For this, and send it back. We'll take it. Do what? Third quarter basketball about to get underway from the Mabee Center on the campus of Oral Roberts University. Michael Knight, Matt Reynolds courtside here. Kenneth Rumsey, our in-studio producer on the video side of things. Thomas Walkingstick, our director on OKHardwood.tv. 38-29 is our score. Owasso on top. Memorial with ball moving right to left as we start the third quarter. Ellison left open in the corner for three. He misses the open one. Milton with the rebound. He runs it up the floor. Tosses it into the corner to Seafluth. Seafluth drives, picks up his dribble, goes to Lowe. Lowe does the same thing, throws it to Milton. Left-hand layup, good.
Beautiful. Beautiful drive by Milton. Splitting through the defenders with ease.
16 points for Milton. 40-29 in favor of the Rams. Nero has it. In between the two circles, Lambert standing at the top of the key waiting for him. Guest has it right wing. Pro hop into the lane. Jumper, no good. Got his own miss somehow. Tosses it underneath to A.J. Cockle. Cockle working past Anderson. He's just too much underneath. Anderson plus doesn't want to get in foul trouble here. As Milton tosses right to Lambert. Lambert goes to Lowe. Lowe picks up his dribble, bounce past to Milton. On the drive, runs over Bosco Style, puts up a shot, no good. Bosco Style did not have his feet set in time. And Milton will get free throws.
Shake Milton starting off the second half very aggressive and strong. He got a lot of rest in the first half. I got to assume that that had to help him get his legs under him. They're actually going to say this foul is on the floor.
Interesting. Milton inbound, pass to Anderson. Anderson, top of the key to Seafluth, right wing to Milton. Milton pump fakes for three, drives. Thought about shooting at the free throw line, passes to Seafluth. Seafluth drive, shot, no good. Rebound, tipped out to Boskostock. Guest has it, left wing, drives into the paint, tosses out to Ellison. Ellison, pro hop, and then throws it away. Turned around, he thought Guest would be in the corner, he wasn't there. It goes out of bounds and over to Owasso.
Cannot afford to have empty possessions like that, you at least need to get off the shot and give your chance, give yourself a chance.
Lambert crosses half court. Nearly 2 minutes into the third quarter, Owasso still leads by 9. That was their lead at halftime. Low goes top of the key to Seafloo. Seafloo wanted to go back door cut to Milton and was guarded. Anderson has it high post right side. Airballs that one. Leaves a Welsh Memorial on the race. Going coast to coast for the layup is Caleb Muro. Very impressive. Young man getting to the basket in a hurry and finishes with the right hand. Pulls Memorial within 7, only to have Kinzer Lambert immediately respond on the other end with a layup. 41-33. Lambert 42-33.
Lambert now has 13.
Guest back the other way. Layup no good. Cockrell there with a putback double-double for A.J. Cockrell. He's got 18 and 10-plus rebounds. 42-35. Lambert pull up Trey. Leaves this one short. Taylor Ellison controlled the rebound. Gets it to Guest. I think Lambert got caught up in the moment. As both teams moving a little faster, pull up 3, not really what they wanted. Cockrell with a pull up jumper, now goes underneath after getting his offensive board. Lowered his shoulder and put it into DeShannon Lowe. Easy call for the referee as Cockrell just trying to get position underneath. But at the same time, Matt, you can't lower your shoulder like that underneath.
This isn't football. Anytime you lower your shoulder, it's not going to be a good thing in the game of basketball. Easy call there for the ref.
Milton walks it across half court. Under 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Anderson now has the top of the key. Trying to go underneath the
pass.
Somehow Milton got it. Goes up for the basket. Count it. And give him a free throw as he was fouled on the attempt.
And give the assist to Michael Anderson. Great touch from the big man. He passed all the way from the left wing all the way inside there to Milton.
I was going to just say how terrible of a pass that, or how terrible of a decision to pass.
It wasn't a good decision, but.
The window was airtight.
It was a needle in a haystack, him finding that. But the fact that the pass got to shake him,
impressive.
I'm giving him big time credit.
Impressive.
Because he was triple teamed down low.
I don't know how Milton got that. He made the free throw. It's 45-35, 4:44 left in the third quarter. Give Shake 19 points on the night. He's got 109 points for the tournament. Derek Guest driving on the baseline. No good. 109 points. That puts him in the top 5.
Place.
All alone in 5th place in 3-game scoring in Tournament of Champions history.
Big time.
Not bad. Inbound pass to Cockrell, top of the key. Turns around, tosses to Guest. Guest will walk it back towards half court. Now angle to his left and toss back to Nero, the sophomore point guard. Really playing older than just being a sophomore. I don't think he played at all last year for the Chargers. Guest on the attack. Shot no good. DeShannon Lowe skying over 6'8" A.J. Cockrell to come down with a rebound. Blake Hamer on the other end. Shot no good. Anderson offensive board. Blocked from behind by Ellison. He was fouled going up. We'll go to the free throw line to shoot 2 nearing the halfway mark of the third quarter.
A.J. Cockrell went for the block there on the initial shot, allowing Michael Anderson to be wide open by himself for the offensive board. And give credit to Anderson as he immediately went straight up after the rebound, put it up.
In and out on the first free throw. Taking a look at the Owasso bench, Mark Van Kieren, former Oklahoma State Cowboy, Brian Montanati. Now the TU football commit, Michael Anderson, which, by the way, I spoke with Michael earlier this week, and he said he loves the new hire of Philip Montgomery at Tulsa, and he remains 100% committed to the Golden Hurricane. He can sign his letter of intent with TU on February 4th. Chargers have a top of the key after 2 misses. Entry pass to Cockrell. Cockrell baby hook in the lane. Bounces off the front iron and off the backboard and in.
Cockrell's having one heck of a game. Already has the double-double now, 20 points.
He could possibly have his second consecutive 2020 game. Kinzer Lambert on the attack. Shot, no good. Put back, no. His foul going up. I believe Derek Guest got him.
Foul number 22, Derek Guest, his second personal foul, 15.
It is key that it was on Guest and not Cockrell, as if that's on Cockrell.
Kinder Lambert at the line.
Give him four fouls. AJ really the only thing keeping Memorial in the game for the second half.
Lambert. Look at the wrist at the free throw line, knocks it down, 46-37 in favor of the Rams. Memorial can't put a dent into this lead. Nero hands off to Guest. Guest top of the key. Goes right wing to Ellison, who launches for three in and out. No good to Shannon Love with the rebound. Up ahead to Hamer. Hamer back to Love. 3 minutes left in the third quarter. Love picks up a dribble, hands off to Love, who drives. Floater with the right hand, no good. Tipped out of bounds by Carson. It should stay with Owasso. Carson that time just tried to tip it away from Shake Milton. Batted it out of bounds.
That's normally a smart play. Don't let the ball touch Shake Milton's hands.
I give him the benefit of the doubt anyway. I wouldn't want him to have it. Inbound pass, nice pass to Anderson, who finishes on the right side. 48-37 in favor of the Rams. Anderson quietly has 8 points. Cockrell in the corner. He goes left wing to Nero. Nero working on DeShannon Lowe. Gets some separation, doesn't take advantage of it. Goes top of the key, now right wing to Guest. Guest into the corner. They're trying to get it underneath Cockrell. They do, but he misjudged the pass. Goes out of bounds and over.
Pass was off to the right then. Cockrell's went a little bit more to the left.
Cockrell said that he got tied up with Michael Anderson. He wanted a foul call. Didn't get it. Kenzer Lambert trapped at the backcourt. He throws it away. Intended for Lowe. Lowe got taken out on the play. Couldn't get to the pass from Lambert. Ball goes over to Memorial. Bounce pass to the right wing. Guest has it. He drives and just lost it off of his foot. Trying to blow past Lambert, lost control of the basketball. He goes out of bounds. Bobby Allison wants a timeout. Memorial takes time. With 2 minutes and 10 seconds left, the Chargers cannot put a dent into this lead. It remains double digits, 48-37. Rams on top. Shake Milton has 19. A.J. Cockrell with 20. We'll take time as well. This is the 2014 Tournament of Champions title game on OK Hardwood, and your home for sports animals.
From two stories to 20. From ready apps to emergency response. From your community to a nationwide network. The cleanup specialists at 1-800-SERVPRO. Everything under your roof, everyone under ours. Helping to make fire and water damage like it never even happened.
Out in full court pressure, nearly steal the ball away. DeShannon Lowe comes up with it. He goes to Lambert. Lambert up ahead to Anderson. Anderson can't get there in time. Ball goes out of bounds and over to Memorial.
Back-to-back turnovers there. Something the Rams cannot do, or maybe Memorial can find their way back in this one.
Three ball on the way. Nero knocks it down. That'll what a big help. Shot from the sophomore.
That will certainly help. By the way, Shake Milton just went to the bench for a while, so getting some more rest.
I just I don't know if he's hurt. He's not acting like he's hurt. Hamer up ahead to Lowe. Lowe back to Hamer. Hamer trying to get past two defenders. Goes up to Seafloop. Seafloop tosses left to Lowe. All alone for three. Leaves it short. Cockle skies for the rebound. Up ahead to Carson. Carson battling in between two defenders. Throws up the shot. No good. Right wing to Guess, who launches for three. Got it.
We have a game on our hands. 5-point game now. A huge shot in the right wing from Guest.
6-0 run for the Memorial Chargers out of the timeouts. And it makes it 48-43. A minute 6 left in the third quarter. Owasso needs a timeout. 30-second timeout. We just stepped aside. Plus, the quarter's almost over. We'll keep it right here. Does Shake Milton come back out of this timeout?
No.
No.
Just wrestling. Final minute 6, then let him play the full quarter. That's about it.
Do you think that it's just resting?
Yeah, I don't
think. Or do you think something's wrong?
I don't think anything's wrong at all. If there is anything wrong, maybe he has a flu or something. But
it is really cold.
It is really cold.
Not in the baby sound.
Well, it's very cold outside, so maybe he has a cold. Maybe that's a good point. Shake does come back on the floor. I don't think he's hurt, though, anything serious. Maybe he is feeling a little off or something. Or maybe he's just tired. He's had a busy 3 days.
Contrary to popular belief, Shake Milton is human.
Yep.
And he has the ball out of the timeout.
Great defense by A.J. Cockrell.
Literally just stood straight up. Didn't move at all. And Milton misses the layup. Memorial with the ball. Cockrell pass underneath to Carson. Milton. Going to get whistled for the foul.
And that is Shake's fourth foul.
Maybe he was sitting out because he's in foul trouble.
I don't think so.
No, he's not. But that is his fourth personal foul. Now he's going to have to sit down.
We'll see how this Owasso team responds. They've had Shake Milton out for a lot more than they normally do. See if they can pick up the slack here.
Guest has it in the corner. Left wing now. Out. Goes into the paint to Cockrell. Cockrell up and under shot. Rolls around. No good. He'll go to the free throw line to shoot two with 39.2 seconds left. But now it's different for Owasso because before they were sitting Shake as a luxury, just resting him up because they had a lead. They had a 7-point lead. They had an 8-point lead. They had an 11-point lead. Whatever it may be. It was a luxury before. Now they have to sit him because it's a necessity. He has 4 fouls. You don't want him fouling out.
No doubt about it. And we look on Memorial's side, A.J. Cockrell, he has 3 fouls. He stood straight up on the other end because he can't afford to get this 4th foul on him.
Correct.
He's having a big night with now 22 points.
Made both of them. 39.2 seconds left. It's a 1-possession game.
Cockrell's going to get a rest again. I love Coach Allison's philosophy, getting him some extra rest, taking him off the course.
Lambert, bounce pass to Lowe. Lowe back to Lambert. Lambert up ahead to Seafloop. Back to Lambert. 30 seconds left. Rams lead by 3 in the third quarter. Tosses right to Lowe. Lowe with a handoff to Hamer. Hamer, dribble drive, nearly loses control of it. Back out to Lambert. Into the corner to Seafloop. Goes back to Hamer. Hamer to Lowe. Man, without Shake on the floor. Not a lot of movement here on the Owasso offense.
7 seconds.
Lambert running to the basket. Wild layup up and no good.
That'll
he
work.
Was fouled with 4.7 seconds left.
If you're Owasso, that's exactly what you want to see. Working around, being patient, and then finally there was a hole, as well as time was running down, so Kendrick Lambert went and drove to the basket. Found himself on the free throw line.
Lambert was hit and miss. First half from the charity stripe. Showing some promise, the 2016 prospect, junior. Makes both free throws and puts this lead back up to 5, 50-45, 4.7 seconds left. Taylor Ellison will check back in for Memorial, the sharpshooter specialist. Say that 3 times fast. Nero quickly into the front court, the sophomore off the glass at the buzzer. Caleb Nero with the runner in the lane as time expires. Puts this lead back down to 3. It's 50-47. And we are at the end of 3 quarters.
Could have another exciting finish.
With 1 quarter and possible overtime. Knock on wood. I hope there's an overtime. It'd be great. Sign me up. Been here for 12 hours. Make it 13. 50-47. Owasso on top of Memorial. Shake Milton dealing with foul trouble with four fouls. A.J. Cockle getting close to another 20-20 game. He already has 20-plus points, working on close to 16 rebounds. We'll be back after 30 seconds for the fourth and final quarter. After this, on your home for the TOC, Sports Animal.
Under the roof of a home or business, damage can happen. When it does, turn to the specialists who put help in the palm of your hand. The Ready App and Emergency Response Plans from 1-800-SERV-PRO, like it never even happened.
Fourth and final quarter has begun here at the Maybe Center. Michael Knight, Matt Reynolds, both side here. Backdoor cut to Seafloops. Finishes with a right hand. Nice pass from Blake Hamer. Shake Milton still sitting out with four personal fouls. Rams now lead 52-47. A.J. Cockrell back on the floor for Memorial with 22 points. Driving to the basket on the baseline was Jalen Alexander, who turns the ball over. Blake Hamer set to inbound. Full court pressure from Memorial. Some trap action as well.
The pressure Hamer is what's got Memorial back in this game.
DeShannon Lowe crosses half court, passes to Lambert. Lambert, as Memorial backs off, finds Hamer. Hamer drives baseline. Nice drop pass to Anderson, who finishes 54-47. Anderson has 10 points. He's in double figures. And Memorial now trails by 7. A little 4-0 run to start the fourth quarter for the Rams. Caleb Nero bounce pass into the corner. Now tosses it to the free throw line to Guest. Guest attacking the basket. Off the glass and in. Count it. He's going to the free throw line to shoot one.
Big time shot there by Guest. And Memorial is just hanging around, lying in the weeds. What do you know? This game is just a 5-point game. Could end up being 4. Guest can hit this free throw. The perfect scenario for Memorial. Shake Milton is on the bench. He's easy to stop when he's on the bench.
Can't score many points from there, man.
You can't.
Guest converts on the free throw.
Unless you're fading away, inbounds, release the ball, and then fall on the bench. That's about the only way I can score.
Not many of those plays happen, though. 54-50 is the score, 6:43 left in the contest. Kinsler Lambert spinning around a defender, finds Hamer, no look pass in the corner for three, air mails it to A.J. Cockrell. Up ahead goes Carson. Carson surveying the defense, tosses left to Alexander, back to Carson. 6:15 left in the contest, 54-50 in favor of the Rams. Pass to Guest, nearly went over his head. He got it at the free throw line. Shot good. Lambert just went off of him and left him open to hit that jumper.
Big time shot there by Guest. Guest coming on here in the fourth quarter. Coming up big so far from Memorial.
Under 6 minutes to go. It's now a 2-point advantage for Owasso. And guess who's at the scorer's table for the Rams? Mr. Milton. Blake Hamer goes top of the key to DeShannon Lowe, who drives on the left side. Finger roll layup, no good. Up ahead goes Caleb Nero. Nero has it poked away by Anderson from behind. Lambert to his left to Anderson. Anderson top of the key to Lowe, now right wing to Lambert. Lambert, before he could toss a pass to the top of the key, there's a foul away from the ball. I believe they're going to call that on the player for the first time, Nick Thompson. Now Nick Thompson will sit down, checking in with four personal fouls is Shake Milford.
Shake has a very high basketball IQ. He will need to use it at all times here to make sure he's not fouled out of this.
19 points for Milton, 54 to 52. Memorial thought about a three, driving baseline, pulling up is Nero. He nearly hit that on the baseline. Jay, he was fouled going up. He'll go to the free throw line to shoot two. Caleb Nero, the sophomore, has quietly put up 15 points in this game.
15 big points, and Mike, when you look at this game, in the third quarter, Memorial, at times they even looked out of this game. They're down by 11, which you never count them out, obviously, but they just never looked like they were going to be able to get anything going. Shake Milton then goes for a rest, and Memorial has capitalized in a big part of that. Memorial went to this pressure, got a few turnovers, and then started converting those turnovers into points.
Nero made the first free throw. Second free throw on the way. Rattles it in, and we're tied. 54 apiece, 5 minutes to go. Milton.
Went overtime.
Running the point for the Rams. He goes to the left, blows right past Vasco style. The shot no good, draws the foul.
He went overtime, we might just get it.
Everything about this kid is Kevin Durant.
I'm telling you, everything. It's the exact idea. Somebody asked me, actually more than one person asked me today about the kid. Been hearing about him, and I'm like, you watched Kevin Durant play? Yes. Okay, he plays just like Kevin Durant. He's not as tall, obviously. Not as skilled, obviously, as Kevin Durant. But he is a high school version, I think, of Kevin Durant.
I think you can say he's probably as skilled or close to as skilled as Kevin Durant was when he was in high school.
It's pretty close.
I think you could make that statement. Saying he's as skilled now is preposterous. One man's the NBA MVP, the other yeah. is a senior in high school. Under 5 minutes to go, Milton goes one of two at the charity stripe. Underneath to A.J. Cockrell, he's got it! Cockrell's got the basket, count it, and give him a free throw on the foul. A pass underneath to A.J. Cockrell gave Memorial a 56-55 lead.
Big time basket there by A.J. Cockrell.
At the free throw line.
We talked a lot about Shake and AJ in this game. Last night we had the matchup of Chris Crawford against Shake Milton. Tonight we've got another great from AJ Cockrell versus Shake Milton.
AJ nails the free throw and puts Memorial up by two, 57-55. I don't think they've had the lead at all in this contest, so definitely a 2-point advantage is their largest lead. 4.5 minutes left, Memorial up by two. A.J. has 25. Lambert launches for three and takes the lead right back. Lambert with 18 points.
That
also up one.
Is a big-time shot.
Bounce pass underneath to Cockrell. Cockrell getting some space. Shot no good. Guest skying for the putback. Can't get it. Rams off to the races. They have numbers. Lambert attacking Ellison. Nearly runs him over. Count the basket and the foul. 4 minutes and 3 seconds left. Lambert standing at the free throw line to put Owasso up by two possessions.
Kenzer Lambert taking over this game right now. He's got 20 points, and he is a huge reason why Owasso is ahead right now by 3 points. As here in the fourth quarter, Kenzer making big things happen so far.
Lambert converts on the free throw, giving 21 on the night. That's one more point than Shake Milton. We reached the halfway mark of the fourth quarter, 61-57. Nero pulling up for three, he's got it. What a big shot by
the sophomore.
Right
there, did you say this kid is?
Sophomore.
He is not playing anything like a sophomore.
Sophomore. The media timeout by Bobby Allison. With 3 minutes and 50 seconds left.
Big
step aside for 30 seconds. This is the Tournament of Champions title game on both OK Hardwood and your home for sports and sports animal.
From restoring damage in just one room to an entire building, turn to the cleanup team that's here in your community and here to help at 1-800-SERV-PRO, like it never even happened. From residential to commercial, from large loss to emergency response, Whenever damage strikes, call on the cleanup team that's faster to any size disaster at 1-800-SERV-PRO, like it never even happened. Under the roof of a home or business, damage can happen. When it does, turn to the specialists who put help in the palm of your hand. The Ready App and Emergency Response Plans from 1-800-SERV-PRO, like it never even happened.
There he is!
Oh shit, I wasn't listening.
Goodness.
Please don't do anything. Matt, run on the floor and spill something.
Jason Kidd.
It's like he knows. Back to action under 4 minutes to go. Owasso on top 61-60. Shake Milton attack the Memorial defense. And before he hit the shot off the glass, he was fouled on the floor. He gets free throws regardless. He makes the front end of 1-1. Mighty Mike Matt Reynolds courtside here at the Maple Center. 2014, 50th anniversary of the TOC championship game. Milton struggled from the free throw line in his last couple of trips, shooting 50%. 2-4 on his last two trips. He misses the second. It's 62-60 in favor of Owasso. The sophomore that's not playing like a sophomore, Caleb Miro, who has 20. He's controlling the point for Memorial right now. In the corner, they go to Carson. Carson out to Ellison, who slings it to Nero, guarded by Lambert. Gets a pick, angles to his right. Working on low, trying to get some separation. Using a pick, goes to Carson. Under 3 minutes to go, Owasso leading by two. Carson to Nero, right wing, trying to go underneath to the big man Cockrell, who's guarded by Anderson. Nero goes out to the half court. They're going to reset here. A possession of about 45 seconds down for Memorial.
Keep in mind, Memorial is not the team ahead right now.
Nero working on Lambert, trying to find an opening. They pass it to Carson. Carson going past low. Picks up his dribble. Left wing to Ellison. Now bounce pass to Nero, who drives into the paint, puts up a shot. It's swatted by Lambert, but there's a whistle. Lambert picks up the foul, sends the sophomore to the free throw line. Caleb Nero sitting at the line, shooting two free throws, 62-60. First free throw is up, is good.
Huge free throws right here.
Second free throw is rattled in as well. What a play. What a player by Caleb Nero is. Unbelievable. Full court pressure. As Owasso is knotted up with Memorial. Low in the opening, he has the left wing. Tosses it back to Hamer. Hamer to Milton. Milton has it near half court. He's taking some air out of the ball. With under 2 minutes to go, we're tied at 62. Low, bounce pass out to Milton. Milton pump fakes the pass. Now slings it to Lambert. Lambert angles to his right, now crosses over a defender. Goes back, looking for Milton, finds him, passes to him. Bounce pass back to Lambert. Lambert right wing, he wants to drive, gets some separation, doesn't use it. Goes back to the three-point line. Mark Van Kuren wants a timeout with 1 minute and 27 seconds left. He takes a 30-second timeout. They're tied at 62.
Smart timeout there by head coach of the Owasso Rams, Mark Van Kuren, as You take that timeout, let your team get set, draw up a little play here and get your team going, because I really think we're deadlocked at 62. The next team that can go on a small run, and by small run, heck, it may even be just school, has a great chance of winning this game, as both teams struggling here towards the end of the fourth quarter to get any points on the board. And your best play may be to just, for either team, to go and just flat out just drive in, because more than likely you'll get a foul.
It's high school basketball all the time.
Let's see what Owasso draws up out of this timeout.
Minute 27 left, 62-62. Lambert set to inbound. 35 feet away from his basket. Memorial gonna double team Milton. They get it to Milton anyway. Milton acted like he was gonna throw it down with a right hand tomahawk, but before he could get into the lane, there was a foul.
Sadly, they fouled. I was hoping to see the right hand tomahawk.
He looked like he was about to throw that thing down with some emphasis. Send Shake to the line. Shake has been shaky at the charity stripe here in the fourth quarter. Makes the first. That was corny. Man, I'm disappointed in myself. 63-62. He's true on both, nothing but net. His last two trips, he went 1-for-2 each time. Goes 2-for-2 that time. Puts Owasso back up by 64-62. Minute 20 left in the contest. Guest tosses it back to Carson. Carson walks across half court. The Memorial Chargers trying to knock off the Owasso Rams. Owasso trying to take some momentum into 2015. Remain unbeaten. Carson in between the two circles. Tosses right to Nero, who's playing much wiser than a sophomore. Nero working around a defender before the 5-second call. Bobby Allison wants a timeout with 55 seconds left.
And if you're Memorial right here, the obvious move is try to get the ball into AJ Cockrell. If you can't do that, Caleb Nero, just a sophomore, I wouldn't mind putting the ball in his hands on the night that he's had today.
He had that play at the end of the third quarter where he ran coast to coast and got the little runner in the lane. For the most part, Cockrell's been relatively quiet here in the fourth quarter. It's been guys like Caleb Nero and some other pieces around him that have come up big and helped the Chargers not only remain in this game, but have a chance to win it here. 55 seconds left, 64-62. Inbound pass to Guest. Guest crosses half court. Under 50 seconds left. Rams on top by two. Guest spinning around Lambert. He drives in the corner. Ellison for three. Got it!
Oh, my gosh.
Taylor Ellison puts the Chargers on top. 65-64. What a shot from the sharpshooter senior. Shake Milton driving to the basket. Shot is good. No foul. There was contact. Clock still running, under 20 seconds left, 66-65. How did Shake Milton make that?
What a game this is.
Caleb Nero crosses half court, 12 seconds, driving to the basket, puts up the shot, no good, there's a foul.
Wow.
Memorial does not have any timeouts left.
This is one heck of a ball game. Could both of our championship games go into overtime? Think about it. How crazy would that be?
Caleb Nero standing at the free throw line. The first one ties it up, but Mark Van Kuren's going to make the sophomore think about it. He takes one of his three timeouts that he has left. Give him two. And with 9.4 seconds left, it's a 60-second timeout. We'll step aside for 30. When we come back, sophomore Caleb Nero will try to put the Memorial Chargers on top of Owasso. It's 66-65 right now. This is your home for sports and your home for the Tournament of Champions. Sports Animal.
two stories to 20. From ready apps to emergency response. From your community to a nationwide network. The cleanup specialists at 1-800-SERVPRO. Everything under your roof, everyone under ours. Helping to make fire and water damage like it never even happened.
Lambert has 21. Nero.
First one's big. It'll take a lot of pressure off the second.
Oh, in and out.
Crowd letting them hear it. This one is huge.
The fans directly behind us are the Owasso contingent. And Mark Van Curen uses another timeout.
Ice. That's what he's doing right now.
Can't take him with you.
A lot of ice, man. Put right now on the stripe, free throw line.
It's slippery.
It's a frozen lake.
66 to 65.
Maybe center is flooded.
Someone's gonna hear you like out of turn and be like, what?
Hey, it's not literally flooded.
A couple weeks ago, the electricity was out here.
Yeah, that is true.
Weird things happen.
Yeah.
Okay. Caleb Nero has about 30 seconds left in the timeout. He's standing at the free throw line anyway. He doesn't care. Bobby Allison, Memorial head coach, trying to lead the Chargers to a come from behind win.
If you Nero. Miss this free throw and don't get the rebound in your Memorial, immediately you have to foul.
You hope number three for the Rams doesn't get the rebound as he is on the floor. Nero stepping to the charity stripe. 9 seconds left. Down by one. The sophomore's already missed one. Throws it up. Got it. Nothing but net. We're tied. 66 all. Shake Milton has it. Crosses half court with the left hand. Angles to his left. Works around a defender. 3 seconds. Goes to the basket. Loses it. Lambert has it. Shot at the buzzer. No good. We've got overtime.
Can you believe it?
The Owasso coaches thought that there was contact enough for there to be free throws on Milton. I thought Milton, at first I thought he just lost it, but now thinking back, watching it in my mind, it looked almost like a pass to Lambert because Lambert was in the right place at the right time. He had a shot with about 2 seconds left. He missed it. Anderson was there for a putback. It was off the mark as well. And we got back-to-back overtime games.
You said, is this the best tournament champions ever? Well, heck, I think we may be getting our answer right here.
Crown it.
We have crowned it. The best ever, the 50th.
Take that for an anniversary. How's that? Best ever in the history. 50 years. It was all building up to this.
It's been a great one. Back-to-back overtime games. You can't ask for anything.
Other games that were fantastic, not only today, yesterday, Monday. It has been an unbelievable 3 days here in Tulsa, both at Veterans Arena on Monday, although there were a bunch of blowouts there, but still, unbelievable TOC, the Owasso Rams, and the Memorial Chargers heading into overtime.
Now, something to point out here. We saw in the Muskogee game earlier on with East Central, in that overtime game, they were without their best player, that is Muskogee, Aaliyah Wilson. 5 fouls. Shake has 4 fouls. Gotta be careful still. Cannot allow him to get 5 fouls. He's gotta play very smart here in this overtime period.
Overtime about to begin.
The fish is sorting out something. I don't exactly know what.
Shake Milton would like Derek Guest to move over to the left. Some confusion at half court. Interesting. Interesting to say the least. AJ Cockles ready to go. Kinzer Lambert won the tip. But there's a whistle.
Did they just give a foul on a tip? That's not possible, is it?
No, it's not possible.
I was about to say.
It's a violation on Cockrell. It gives Owasso the ball, even though Lambert won the tip anyway. Milton has it. He drives to the basket. Shot. Good.
Wow.
Nearly blocked by Cockrell. It bounces in 68-66. 15 seconds in. Also involved in an overtime game last night. They beat Victory Christian by 4. Derek Guest to A.J. Cockrell. Leaves the layup short. Got his own miss. The putback is good. And he's fouled. Surely he has at least 20 rebounds now.
He's a man among boys. Man among boys. A.J. Cockrell. I knew coming into this tournament, Shake Milton was obviously very, very, very good.
Yes.
Everybody knew that. But I think A.J. Cockrell is showing Tulsa and the state of Oklahoma. Hello, I'm right here.
Made the free throw, and that's the number one reason why I made him my player to watch coming into this tournament. Everybody knew about Shake Milton. Everybody knew about Chris Crawford. The Tournament of Champions was an opportunity for A.J. Cockrell to break out onto the scene as one of the elite players in Oklahoma. And he's doing that right before our eyes. 69-68, the Chargers on top. Cockrell has 28 and at least 20 rebounds. Milton loses control of the ball in the paint. He was fouled by Carson.
Boy, are we getting some great basketball here. I would pay to see these games, but I'm glad I don't have to.
I'm glad I don't have to pay to see them. But 24 games, let's see.
That'd be a lot of more time.
Milton at the free throw line makes it. Had a message that this is not the best TOC as Milton battles home the second, 70-69. Back in 1995, Booker T. Washington and John Marshall played in the championship game, and 8,000 people were there to see it.
Well, we don't have 8,000, but we do have great basketball.
It's a really good game, though. Derek Guest at the free throw line picks up his dribble. He goes to Caleb Nero in the corner. Now he drives. The sophomore with a layup. It's in. Caleb Nero puts Memorial back on top, 71-70.
Talk about breaking out. Caleb Nero, the sophomore, is breaking out tonight.
25 points. Milton in the paint. Just throws it up. It's off the mark to the left. Cockrell with a rebound. Guest up ahead to Nero. Nero trapped. Throws it out to Guest left wing. He drives with the right hand. Goes all the way to the hoop. Shot no good. He was fouled going up. He'll go to the free throw line with 2:21 left in Memorial on top, 71-70.
Free throws are going to become very, very key down the stretch of this one.
Bend to the knees, and he throws the first one up. It rattles in for Derek Guest, who has 11 points. 2:21 left. Memorial now on top by 2. In and out on the second. Milton grabs the rebound, 72-70. He's attacking with the left hand. Shot, no good. He was fouled on the floor.
Still will be awarded 2 free throws nevertheless, as both teams well into the double bonus here tonight.
Sending Shake Milton to the free throw line, 72-70. Milton can tie things up. Missed it.
Very unshake-like there.
Made the second. Memorial still on top, 72-71.
Give Shake 30 points for the game tonight.
Nearly stolen away by Lowe. Up ahead goes Nero. He had it poked away by Lambert. Anderson is there on the ground. He picks it up and goes to Lambert. There's a foul on Michael Anderson.
Are they going to timeout? Timeout, no. Mark Van Curen.
Anderson grabbed the loose ball. Van Curen didn't have to call timeout. He immediately got it to Lambert, but Van Curen does use his timeout here with 2 minutes and 3 seconds left. He still has one left from regulation. They trail 72-71.
Van Curen ran all the way down to half court, and I got the coach a hand clap there because you never know. When your player's on the floor with the ball, you just are thinking, I've got to get the timeout, and he did exactly what he needed to do. He ran down all the way to the official and called the timeout. And this will be a big possession coming up for Owasso. Owasso needs to get something going here, needs to get a score here. So we've got 2 minutes to play. This game could go either way. We've seen it. It just is going to come down to the last couple of plays, as it does in every game, and we'll see how it falls. But right now, Shake Milton definitely starting to get going. He's got 30 points, and it seems anytime Shake drives in the lane, he's either going to score or he's going to at least get to the line.
Let's say there was a jump ball and there was a tie-up when Anderson was on the floor. Possession arrow favors Memorial.
Exactly.
Great timeout by Van Curen, I agree.
No doubt about it, one of the best timeouts we've seen in the complete tournament. Memorial is going to press coming out of this timeout. See how the Rams handle the pressure, as this press is really the reason why Memorial is where they're at now and back in this game with the lead.
Milton up ahead to Seafluth. Seafluth, as we're back to action. Shake drives all the way to the basket, in and out on the floater. He was fouled going up. He's going back to the free throw line.
I mean, exactly what I said. It doesn't matter what Shake does. If he just drives the ball every time, he's going to at least have a chance to go to the free throw line.
First free throw on the way, nothing but net. 72-72, a minute 51 left. Second free throw on the way, got it. Owasso on top, 73-72.
Owasso now showing some pressure on defense, full court press.
Derek Guest up ahead. He goes to Carson. Carson in the lane, shot no good. He's going to have free throws.
It's a foul fest, and who are they going to give the foul to? Is this against?
Max Seafluth.
That's very key if you're wondering why it's such a big deal, is because Shake was right there around the play, and Shake Milton has four fouls for Owasso. Memorial has no one with four fouls, but three players with three fouls, so we could see some foul trouble down the line if this thing goes into double overtime. I believe that was actually Max Seafluth's fifth foul.
Yeah, he just fouled out.
So, I mean, that's just showing you that's one player, but we could have many more foul out here down the line.
Standing at the free throw line, Alante Carson. First free throw, no good. Left it short.
Needs this one to tie it. A lot of pressure. Fans are letting him hear it.
73-72. Carson, bend of the knees. Puts this one up. He left that one short, too. Rebound to Milton.
Legs are tired in this one.
Milton across half court. He crosses half court, and he just takes the air out of the ball. He's just going to stand there. He's going to make Memorial guard him, and now he's on the move. Moving around the perimeter. Ellison and Guest are there to trap him. He tosses it to Hamer, who gives it right back to him. Guest is there, along with Ellison. Hamer hands off to Milton. Milton driving to the basket, met by Cockrell. He misses it. Rebound tipped out to Ellison. Memorial with a shot. 1 minute left. Guest and Memorial down by two. Cockrell underneath. Shot no good. Rebound being fought for, won by Anderson after the miss by Cockrell.
Lots of contact there on both sides.
Milton with it at half court. He's moving around the backcourt. There's a foul on Derek Guest with 45 seconds left. Wow.
Lots of contact. These are very key free throws because if Shea can hit both of these free throws, the best Memorial can do is tie the game.
At least on this possession. Rattles that one off. No good on the free throw for Shake Milton, who is not himself from the charity stripe tonight.
You can definitely tell the legs of Shake Milton, they're very tired. He's played a lot of minutes in this tournament.
Rattles this one home, 74-72, 45 seconds left. Inbound to Guest, who gives it right back to Carson. Memorial with one timeout. Carson surveying the defense. Trying to give it to Nero, 30 seconds left. Bounce pass to Guest, right wing, floats it underneath to Cockrell, got it! Tie ball game, 74 all.
Huge basket by AJ in between two defenders. And time going off the clock, Owasso having trouble getting it in.
30 points for Cockrell, 10 seconds left. Milton, pass half court, we're tied at 74. Driving to the basket, runs over AJ Cockrell, and he runs him over. Cockrell fouls out Shake Milton. Cockrell met him underneath the basket. That is Shake's fifth and final foul. He has just fouled out with 4 seconds left.
Shake can't believe it.
And we're tied at 74.
Shake can't believe it. And I kind of alluded to it.
Wow.
We could have some players foul out. The biggest player on the floor that has the biggest effect in this game just fouled out with his fifth foul. And Shake's going to finish with 33 points. Big night from that young man.
Milton has to sit down. I believe he finished with 30 points.
So he's in the top five for sure in scoring, if you're wondering for a halftime stat.
Derek Guest up ahead, 2 seconds left. Pulls up for three at the buzzer, leaves it short. Double overtime.
Did you ask to be broadcasting at midnight?
It's 11:05.
Hey, I said we needed 7 overtimes to do it. We may just We may just need about 4 or 5.
We got 2, at least.
Kenny, we apologize.
Yeah, our poor in-studio producer, Kenneth Rumsey. I can't believe it. 74-74. We're stepping aside for 30 seconds. When we come back, we got double overtime. Shake Milton has fouled out. AJ Cockrell has 30 points. We'll be back with double overtime. Maybe we'll have a winner after 4 more minutes. Maybe not. I wouldn't argue with that. I'd be
triple
okay.
Triple overtime.
I'd be okay with 3.
Quadruple.
I know Rumsey isn't. We got to hit a break. When we come back, double overtime from the Maybe Center. Here on your home for sports, the Sports Animal.
From 2 stories to 20. From ready apps to emergency response. From your community to a nationwide network. The cleanup specialists at 1-800-SERVPRO. Everything under your roof, everyone under ours. Helping to make fire and water damage like it never even happened.
No doubt, this is an instant classic. We're underway. Memorial controls the tap here in double OT, moving right to left. Derek Guest has it on the left wing. They give it off to Carson. Carson with a shot. No good. He walked with it in the paint.
Not only will we have a replay, we'll get a recap. Hopefully by have that up by tomorrow. A little shorter in case you don't have time to watch the full. Cool game.
I might watch the full game tomorrow.
Hey, you might as well.
And I was here.
You've got the semifinal games in football tomorrow, and then you've got this replay.
Yeah, a little picture-in-picture. Nothing wrong with that. 74-74. Owasso with possession. Kinzer Lambert driving to the basket. Shot, no good. He's fouled going up. He'll have two free throws. Lambert now becomes the go-to guy. He's got 21.
And now Lambert in the fourth quarter down the stretch. If you're wondering why you didn't hear his name, it wasn't that he was silent. It was that it was the Shake Milton. Let's get our best player the ball. Let's feed him. Well, now that Shake's gone, it's the Kinzer Lambert show. Feed him the ball. And just a Shake, when you drive in more times than not, either convert or you're going to be fouled.
I know what Mark Van Curen's New Year's resolution is going to be. That his team shoots better from the free throw line in 2015.
No doubt about it.
Lambert goes 1-for-2 from the charity stripe. It's not just him. It's Owasso as a whole tonight has left a lot of points at the
Milton,
free throw line.
Milton's around a 90% free throw shooter, and tonight he left several short.
Yep. 3.5 minutes left. Guest. With Memorial now trailing 75-74, they have Carson on top. Once again, Shake Milton has fouled out. He will not return. They go right wing to Guest, trying to get it underneath to Cockrell. Cockrell needs to get out of the paint. He's been in this lane for 3 seconds. He does. Moving around the perimeter, Carson has it at the free throw line. Bounce pass underneath to Cockrell. Cockrell slams it home. But before he did it, he turned around and walked with it. Why are you slamming your hand? Because you got that dunk perfectly on camera and it didn't count?
It was perfect. Perfect.
You can still use it. They don't have to know that. Under 3 minutes to go, 75-74. Lambert has it right wing, drives into the paint. Shot, no good. And again, he'll go to the free throw line.
It's almost just like Shake Milton. And has just gone and morphed into Kinzer Lambert right now. Obviously, that's a big change and didn't happen. But is what they're playing the exact same as Milton played in the fourth quarter and in the first overtime. Kinzer has now taken over that role.
First free throw on the way. Battles in. 76-74. Second free throw, nothing but net for Lambert. 77-74, 2:45 left. Nero walks it across half court with the left-hand yo-yo dribble. Don't forget, he's had a huge game as well. Sophomore with 25 points here. He has not scored in a while. Guest has it left wing for three, leaves it short. Rebound, Cockrell hits
That's
the deck.
Foul against
We're
going
to have a foul on Michael Anderson.
He clearly pushed AJ to the floor.
That's his fourth personal.
Are you kidding me?
Fans not happy about it, but it was definitely a foul, and that's Anderson's fourth foul, I believe.
Yep, fourth personal.
So we talked about people fouling out. If Owasso's Michael Anderson fouls out, they're going to have a very hard time stopping A.J. Cockrell down low.
Cockrell makes the first and makes it 77-75. AJ now has 31 points. If Memorial wins, he's my MVP.
Oh, there isn't a question.
Second free throw, short and off to the right.
Almost
Lambert
away,
nearly
though.
Had it taken away by Carson from behind. Lambert does control it. 2:15 left, 77-75. Rams on top. Lambert crosses half court. And just like Shake, wanting to take some air out of the ball. Lambert now driving, a little push off with the left arm, gives it to Lowe. Now Hamer wants to drive, right wing to Lambert. Lambert spinning around, he walked with it, and they're going to call it. He lost control on the spin move and turned the ball over.
Tough break there for Owasso. Now Memorial can capitalize and tie this one back up or even possibly take the lead.
Under 2 minutes to go, 77-75. Nero. Guarded by Lowe. Right wing to Ellison for three. Off balance and off to the left. Lowe now throws it away.
Oh, tragic
going to Lambert.
Mistake.
And that's just fatigue.
Tragic mistake. Not one that Lowe normally makes, but just an absolute miscommunication.
Minute 40 left. 77-75. Inbound pass to Guest. Guest guarded by Lambert. Minute 35, Chargers down by two. Bounce pass to Carson, right wing. Carson in the paint, goes out to Nero, top of the key. Nero drives, left baseline to Guest. Guest drives to the hoop, no good. Cockrell's there, basket is good. Are they gonna give him the shot?
And one.
They count the basket, wow.
I tell you what, AJ Cockrell is just a monster down low. We've seen him last year, and last year he obviously had a bunch of seniors on that squad around him. And he was, you know, he wasn't the go-to guy. He just wasn't.
He was the supporting cast.
He was go get rebounds and stuff. This year, he's the go-to man by far.
78-77, Cockrell with 34.
He's probably got over 20 rebounds easily.
At least.
He may be nearing 30.
78-77, A.J. Cockrell leading Memorial to a one-point advantage.
How about after your 20-for-20 game, a 30-for-30 game?
Jeez. Lambert with a response. Kinzer Lambert, a jumper on the high post right side, puts Owasso back up with under a minute to go, 79-78. Carson has it left wing. Cockrell double-teamed underneath. Carson now going to attack, and Bobby Allison wants timeout. Memorial does have two timeouts. Now they're with one, and I noticed underneath you had Blake Hamer in front of A.J. Cockrell, and then Michael Anderson behind him. I'm also not going to make it easy for Memorial to get it underneath to A.J.
They're not, but the thing about that is you're more susceptible, in my opinion, to foul there, because if they somehow get the ball to A.J., you've got two guys down there on him. More than likely, A.J. is going to be able to draw a foul, if not somehow make a shot, and maybe even and one. And the big thing outside of that is if you're double-teaming somebody, somebody is wide open.
And that's what you started to see from Carson there on the left wing. He saw that Hamer was guarding Cockrell and wasn't going to come out. And Carson started to inch a little closer. And he was probably going to pull that little jumper from about 15 feet until Bobby Allison called the timeout.
We'll see what Coach Allison draws up. He may draw a play for Cockrell to get open. If there's any way possible, I'd do the same. But if not, look for Allison outside, maybe to chunk up a three. And obviously, Caleb Nero, what can you say about the sophomore having a big-time night? He's got 25. I'd certainly look for him as well.
I definitely watch for Ellison in the corner. That's a play they love to run out of timeouts. And here he comes. Inbound pass, though, goes to Guest. Guest right wing picks up his dribble, goes to Nero. 40 seconds left. Chargers down by one. Nero working on a defender, crosses him over. Driving into the lane, he walked with it. Is there going to be a call? No.
We're going
to say there's a foul on Owasso. Wow.
Boy. Oh, boy. Would you like three overtimes?
Nero had a similar situation.
It was one of two.
At this point, I don't remember. Was it in the first overtime or at the end of regulation?
It was in the first overtime. He went one of two.
Memorial was down by one. He had a chance to put him up. He only tied him, and he clanks this one.
And the last time at the line, he did the same exact thing, then he knocked down the second free throw. And the last time at the line, Coach Van Curen did the same thing for Owasso. He calls the timeout, tries to freeze the lake right at the free throw line at the Mabee Center here. And it's pretty frozen as Nero heading to the huddle, and I got to imagine.
79-78.
It's got to certainly be on your mind as a player. And I know it's got to be tough setting to a timeout and just wanting to shoot the free throw, especially after a miss.
32 seconds left.
I'm just going to go ahead and say it. I think we're about to hit three overtimes.
I want three overtimes. I know that nobody.
I want seven.
Jeez.
Give us seven. Well, that's what
I
we need to make
seven.
It to. You said you wanted to make it to midnight. We need seven.
It's already 11:17. I don't think we need five more overtimes to accomplish
we
that.
We might.
There might not be enough players on the floor if we go to seven overtimes.
That is true. As players starting to foul out on both sides, should be noted that Memorial now with a little foul trouble themselves as Derek Guest with four fouls. All right, let's see. Can he hit this free throw?
Nero standing at the free throw line trying to tie things up with 32.8 seconds left. He already missed one. The last time in the same situation, he made the second. Free throw is on the way.
Told you.
Same exact situation, nothing but net.
Here we go. Let's see if Owasso can get something with 32 seconds.
Inbound pass to Lambert. Memorial pressures. crosses half court, easily into the front court. Lowe has it. He slipped on the block, gets it somehow to Lambert. 20 seconds left, tied up, 79 apiece. Lambert working on a defender.
Watch the drive with Lambert.
Drives right past him, pull up, floater, off the mark to the left, out to Thompson, back to Lambert, 7 seconds left. Lambert in the lane, shot, no good. This time, ball being fought for, won by Memorial. At the buzzer, it's not gonna count. Off the mark.
I told you, three.
You told me, you're right. Wow, three. Give us three overtimes.
What's the longest? We need to find the longest game ever here.
I don't think overtimes. It's in the record book.
Call somebody up.
Is there a record for most entertaining game?
Because I think this one gets it. I don't care if there was one fan. I don't care if we were the only people here. This is a great game.
It's really, really good. At the end of two overtimes, it's 79-79. Owasso, kudos to the Rams, by the way. We haven't talked about it in a while. They played that entire double overtime. They played that entire double overtime, Matt, without their Gatorade State Player of the Year, Shake Milton.
We have
remain tied.
Hey, get this. I find this hilarious right now. We have a new PA announcer because it's just, I'm going to guess that it's too late.
For old Doc Blevins?
He probably had to go somewhere. I'm sure he had plans.
New Year's Eve,
man.
Doc Blevins. Doc.
He was the MC, so he had to head out.
He was. I have New Year's plans, by the way.
Is that right?
I do.
I hope they're going to be right here.
I'm going to have to cancel them. I guess I have New Year's plans with you.
Well, I guess so.
Did you bring the champagne?
No, I didn't. See, I was thinking, matter of fact, I had New Year's plans in Oklahoma City, so
it way
like
late.
Those are going to happen.
Those are going to have to roll over to next year.
Yep, we'll just roll that to next year.
79-79, Memorial and Owasso playing in an instant classic. Also think about this. Owasso had a game with Glencoe in the first round that featured 66 combined fouls. Yesterday's game went to regular overtime. Today's game is now in triple overtime. And we can't get
we
the
can't
jump.
Get a jump. We're going to have to just jump it about five times.
Why don't you just play rock, paper, scissors at half court to see who's going to
get
ball. The ball.
We get ball. Yes. First. Two out of three.
Owasso wins the tip. Lambert controls the point for the Rams. Working on Carson. Drives right past him. Floater in the lane. Left short. Ball being fought for, won by Nero, tips it out to Guest. Guest, up ahead, crosses half court, working with the left hand. He goes to Carson, left wing. Carson angles back to the top of the key. Thirty seconds into triple overtime, we're still tied up, 79 apiece. Cockle has it, baseline left side.
He was thinking about a three. Then he thought, okay, maybe not. Do you hear the fan behind us?
Shoot the ball.
Right wing to Taylor Ellison. Ellison goes underneath to Cockrell. Finds a wide open Carson who hits the shot. Alante Carson left all alone on the backside. Cockrell did a great job that time. Double teamed underneath. Found Carson for the bucket.
Great patience there by Memorial, and it paid off in the end.
81-79. Low swatted on a drive by A.J. Cockrell.
And the Memorial fans letting them know that his shot was swatted.
2:46 left. It remains with Owasso. Chargers on top, 81-79. Lowe finds Lambert in the corner, almost stolen away by Guest. Lambert has it, though. Controls it, angles back to the right wing. Tosses left to Hamer. Hamer to Thompson. Thompson into the corner to Lowe. Lowe, drive. Floater, no good. Rebound, Memorial.
Here come the Chargers out running.
Nero on the drive, shot no good. He was fouled. Take your pick. Was it Lambert or was it Thompson?
If it's Lambert, he's fouled out. That would be devastating for the Rams. So they. Owasso catching a break there.
Nero at the foul line. He struggled at times, although there's not the same pressure that there is
not
right
at
now. As Nero.
No ice is on the foul line right now at the Mavie Center.
82-79, trying to make it a two-possession game. He does. 2:20 left. Lambert up ahead. Right wing. Working a defender. Goes to the free throw line. Now into the corner to Thompson. He lost it out of bounds. That's just a player who doesn't see a lot of playing time in a clutch situation. Let it go right in between his fingers and out of bounds.
Game is slowly but surely slipping away from Owasso. They need to respond here with a defensive stop.
2 minutes left. Nero drives, loses it to Anderson. Anderson just at the right place, right time on that one.
They got the stop, now they need some points.
Lambert, top of the key, trailing by four, now gives it off to Lowe, Lowe to Hamer. Hamer, back to Lambert, all alone for three, too hard. Minute 35 left, Carson dribbling in between two defenders. Now he's fouled by Lambert, and that's it for Kinzer.
That was a silly foul. Not smart at all. But that, it's going to be hard for the Rams to come back. Now you look to Lowe to lead you, but it's just flat out, it's going to be hard. You lost your two big-time scorers, and if for anybody that's watched this Owasso team, you know it's Shake Milton, then there's a drop-off, then it's Kinzer Lambert, and then there's another drop-off.
I don't think he realized he had four fouls.
Great game by Kinzer Lambert. Had a big-time performance. Tough
Absolutely.
Way to go out. Owasso's going to need Lowe to step up and play big right here.
Anderson, who's had a solid game for the first three quarters, he's been quiet ever since.
He does have 10 points.
Cockrell has made his life very difficult.
There's a foul on the other end.
I believe that's on Cockrell.
This is
it's
huge. One, it's Cockrell's fourth, but the bigger thing is the clock stopped. Wasso's got a chance at the other end to get points on the board with the clock stopped.
84-79. Sends Nick Thompson to the free throw line. First free throw is no good. Both teams do have two timeouts left.
You got to hit those free throws. As tough as it is being in this clutch situation, the Rams need every free throw they can get.
Nothing but net on the second. 84-80, inbound pass to Nero. Nero tosses it to Guest, who immediately crosses half court. 3-on-2. He drives right at Anderson and gets the layup. Memorial up by six. Minute 15.
Rams need a three.
Low, driving into the lane. Layup, no good. Foul on the floor.
Foul on number 15. Alante Carson, his score.
Clutch free throws here. If Low can hit these two free throws with the minute nine, Owasso's still very much in this game.
Makes them both. 86-82. Minute 9 left. Inbound pass to Guest. Guest immediately fouled by Hamer. He'll walk to the other side of the floor to shoot free throws.
Hamer just fouled out. Everybody's fouling out for a while, so. Tough game. Great game, though. No doubt about it. And Memorial still, although there's a lot of young players getting minutes that they're not used to for Owasso, Memorial still needs to make these free throws, because if they miss these two, it's still a four-point game, and Owasso goes to the end and gets a bucket. That's going to give them a little confidence, and I think that may be all they need to tie this game back up and send us into a fourth overtime.
Shh. You're going to make our producer and our director mad. Guest made the free throw. 87 to 82. 5-point advantage. Make it a 6-point lead. Got it.
6-point lead, a minute 7. It's going to be very, very tough for Owasso to come back here.
Timeout. Memorial will take it with them. A minute 7 left. The Chargers on top, 88 to 82. It looks like they're going to win the 50th anniversary of the Tournament of Champions. We'll have the conclusion after this on your home for sports, Sports Animal.
January 12th.
From two stories to 20. From ready apps to emergency response. From your community to a nationwide network. The cleanup specialists at 1-800-SERVPRO. Everything under your roof, everyone under ours. Helping to make fire and water damage like it never even happened. Under the roof of a home or business, damage can happen. When it does, turn to the specialists who put help in the palm of your hand. The Ready App and Emergency Response Plans from 1-800-SERVPRO, like it never even happened.
James Chicken Fingers, always fresh, never frozen.
All right, Bubba's playing, and you're live.
Back to action, Owasso moving left to right. They miss a three ball. Cockrell controls the rebound up to Nero. Nero fouled, and he'll go to the free throw line to shoot two.
This one all but wrapped up. Got to give all the credit in the world to Memorial. I can remember, seems like a day ago, but the third quarter, when Memorial was down by 11 points and just kind of looked out of it. And they just caught fire in the fourth quarter. A big part of that was they went into a press and started pressuring Owasso.
Nero missed the first free throw. He made the second. 7-point lead. More importantly, 3-possession game now. Low, driving, dishes it off to Nick Thompson, top of the key. Thompson goes, drives, shot, blocked by Cockrell, controlled by Ellison, and that should do it. Ellison fouled by Nick Thompson. He'll walk to the other end of the floor to try to hit two free throws. First free throw on the way. Got it. Second free throw on the way. Knocked down. Inbound pass to Lowe. 91 to 82. Lowe finds Thompson, who launches for three. It's off to the right. Rebound, Nero. Nero fouled by Thompson again. 30 seconds left.
Memorial student section making sure it's known that they're going to win this game.
I'm surprised they're still here.
Why not?
Maybe center's emptied out in a hurry.
It has.
In and out for Nero.
Memorial hasn't won the tournament champions in over 10 years. A.J. Cockrell is telling me that that really was the motivation for them coming out and winning this one here this year.
Lowe just knocked down a three after Nero made his second free throw. Inbound pass to Guest, 20 seconds left. Guest working around some defenders, 15 seconds. He's fouled by Sanders, so now Guest can pad his stats at the foul line. Caleb Nero with 30. A.J. Cockrell with 34 and possibly 30. Rebounds.
I hope so. I want to see it 30 for 30 because then I want to ask him after the game, be like, so A.J., you go 20 for 20, your first ever 20 for 20 game yesterday.
What do you do for an encore?
Oh, 30 for 30. Oh, okay. We're making ESPN films.
There's the 30 for 30 on AJ's 30 for 30. Lowe launches for three after a couple made free throws, and he makes it. And another timeout for Owasso and Mark Van Kuren with 6 seconds left. 93-88.
I'll tell you what, you got to give credit to Lowe there. I thought that that's who they were going to go to. Those are actually his first two shots since Kinzer exited the game with Kinzer Lambert exited the game with five fouls. Lowe stepping up, hitting back-to-back threes, but it's just probably going to be just a little bit too late, unless a miracle happens. A steal, a three-pointer, another steal, and a two-pointer at the buzzer.
This game deserves a standing ovation. It's unbelievable. -93-88 inbound pass to Guest. Guest can just dribble it out. 2-1. And Memorial has won the 50th anniversary of the Tournament of Champions behind a fantastic performance by A.J. Cockrell and a surprising performance from Caleb Nero. We'll step aside for a brief timeout. When we come back, we'll have the final stats, and we'll have hopefully both head coach Bobby Allison and Memorial forward A.J. Cockrell after this. Memorial wins it 93-88 in triple overtime. We'll be back in just a couple of minutes on your home for sports, the Sports Animal. When you need to know.
Under the roof of a home or business, damage can happen. When it does, turn to the specialists who put help in the palm of your hand. The Ready App and Emergency Response Plans from 1-800-SERV-PRO. Like it never even happened. From restoring damage in just one room to an entire building, turn to the cleanup team that's here in your community and here to help at 1-800-SERV-PRO. Like it never even happened.
Micah Heron,
Darren Guest. Now the presentation of the Coach's Trophy to Coach Bobby Allison. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the presentation of the gold ball to our champions in the 50th annual tournament of champions to the Memorial Chargers. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have another big hand for both teams who gave us a very exciting game this evening. I'd like to thank you for being with us. I urge you to drive very carefully on your way home.
Extra for overtime?